Okay, now back to API, where to get reliable financial data via API, introduction of the useful data source. Firstly, I always use this financial, always check about this fundamental data. Where I get is this Yahoo Finance. And the Yahoo Finance is very good. It's because so many the library is supporting this Yahoo Finance. And also the API web scrape also available. Normally, like many of the website, they are preventing for us to do like web scraping. So they are still okay, seems like. So we still can get the many data from this website. Where the cons is, not much a technical indicator. Not much technical indicator means they don't have like MACD, they don't have moving average. Those kind of things you have to calculate by yourself, which is because the only thing that I can get is fundamental data or the history of the stock data, which is still okay. But if you want to have like VWAP or moving average, RSI, you need to calculate by yourself. So that's why when we trying to get the technical data, this is another option, which is called this Alpha Vantage. The Alpha Vantage, they provide so many technical indicators, and then that is very useful. I can go to this Alpha Vantage. Alpha Vantage API, right? They have this much. Yeah, you see this? So they have so many technical indicators. You don't have to calculate, you can just grab this data directly. I'm not sure if you, I already explained in the past, my past session, I already explained many of the technical indicators, but if you don't know, you can just go check about my past two session from the YouTube, all archived. So for example, the RSI, right? So the RSI will give us, like 30 is oversell, then the 70 is overbought. So that kind of the number you can get from here. So if you come here, now you see this one, right? So this is number 51, 55, 54. This is the indicator for whether the current market for this product, like for this one is IBM, right? Whether the IBM is sold too much or bought too much, that kind of thing is shown here. Instead of the calculating by yourself, this one is providing the information, which is good. Okay, so let's go back to so the Alpha Vantage here. Next one is Morningstar API. This one is another one, the widely covered exchange. Because most of the thing is covering the US market, but if you want to know about the other market, this one is also usable. Not only the Nasdaq NICE, they're also covering the many of the other exchange too. So, and also the cost is the free version is still not free, which you still need to pay. So, yeah, okay. But anyway, it's not that expensive. Another one, I think 2 weeks ago when I had the workshop for the macroeconomics indicator, I talked about this, the OECD API. So why is this? This one is if you go to this OECD library, this is I can go to here. OECD API if I go there. 자, yeah, this one. So they will give us many of the different kind of the data, like the macroeconomics data, API documentation. Yeah. So okay, let me go back to here. So if you want to know about the GDP, or if you want to know about GDP of the young generation, for example, 20 to 30 years old people, the GDP, or you can categorize, you can just filter, you can just pick up some particular one, which is not just, it's very unusual, because like many of the data, for example, later I will explain, trading economics, that is another API I will explain later. That one doesn't show the doesn't have like a filtering feature, but this one has a filtering feature. However, although I use this one, hard to get the data. If you want to get some particular data, for example, like unemployment rate for the 30 to 39 years old people, or something like that, I can do in this OECD API. But however, and also this one is free. This one is free. And then they will give us the very latest the data. However, it's very hard to use, very difficult. I think if you try to, yeah, it's very hard. Even like from here, from this website, to retrieve some particular data is not that easy. I can show you something. I'm not sure if I can get this there or not. So, because they have so many data, and then gross domestic data, yeah. So they can filter. They can change the filter. Not only here. This one is they provide this GUI, the GUI. But if I use like their the API, I can get more detail. So that one is, but still very hard to use. So I can recommend GitHub and then R language, then OECD. I check about the many of the Python, the library, but they didn't have the good enough one. So for me, I use this library to get the particular data. But I have to use R language. So with this, I can get the more easily for some particular the macroeconomics data. So I can recommend if you want to get some of the particular data from here. So this is another one. Okay, trading economics API. This one is very good, but it's easier compared to this OECD, covering wide data from the macro to the micro. But however, cost is a bit high. So you still need, you have to pay if you want to use this API. Macroeconomics is always showing in this the slide, like here, right? So this one, this is coming from the their website, which is good. But however, if you want to use their API, you have to pay. Okay, so that's the minus point. And then also the Condor API, which is, I think it's very famous nowadays. Process a variety of the data they are providing. And also you can even sell data. If you have some particular data, you can just upload, you can sell it. But however, not sure if this one is reliable or not. Because like many people is providing data. It's kind of data platform, like data marketplace. So Condor, okay, if you go to Condor, this one, this website. The alternative way. So, for example, I can test the GDP. They also have like this kind of like Federal Reserve Bank of America. So they have some data, but if you want to have more accurate data, you may have to pay. They are selling. So this, as I say, this is the marketplace for the data. So, so if you have very precious, particular precious data, then you can sell from here. Okay, so that's another one. So then, I think that many of the company, especially the trading application company, they are also providing API. I'm also using this one, TradeStation Web API. TradeStation is very, very famous for the system trader, and they are one of them. And then the process is you can create the system trader. Means like without you, they will. I just make my own the trading robot, trading bot, and then that will buy and then sell automatically instead of me. And then I can do that by writing my own program. But however, not much the option for the code. Means like unlike the the Yahoo Finance or any other like just now explained here, many platform they have more options, but this one doesn't have much option for the code data data wise. We can do like operation. We can just do execute the order like the sending order, receiving order. Or check about my the budget, those kind of things. I can do that via this API, but it's not. I cannot recommend for getting quote, getting the like the indicator, macro or the fundamental or technical indicator. So that. I believe I recommend people better use other stuff, other API. And also Alpha Wave Data API. This one is also good. Alpha Wave. Alpha Wave. Specifically for the US market, from the macro to micro, they also providing only US data, less options. Again, it's useful. Okay, I can go check about this one. Alpha. Alpha Wave. Yeah, Alpha Wave. Alpha Wave Data. Yeah, so this one is Alpha Wave. Yeah, but anyway. So this one is also good, but again, US data only. Now, what I can recommend for all of you, maybe, one is I can scrape the data. That is one way. Another one is you can just go to their own website, then get the authentication, and eventually you can directly call their API. Another one is this Rapid API. Rapid API is very useful. It's because they actually integrate, unify the data. For example, here, right? For example, the web open with a map data. Oh, it's just slow. COVID-19 data were like this kind of things. Oh, sorry. Okay. I have to. So, this kind of data, and then also, like, you can change the language from here. If you want to have like the example of how to get that API, how to call that API via Go is a language, or PHP, or R language, Python, you can just choose a different the program here. So then they have like example here, and then they will tell us how to code, and they also copy code, yeah, like that. Also, you can choose many different things. For example, the finance. If I just check from the finance, they have a bunch of the different Morningstar also here, Yahoo Financial Data, Yahoo Financial Low Latency, Alpha Vantage is also here, Seeking Alpha. Yeah, so they provide different API, but all of this, the different API into one place. So this is a good platform if you wanna, you don't wanna have like, you don't want to manage like, okay, so this website I have to have this authentication, or this website I have to have this authentication. Instead of doing that, you can just have one authentication, and you can connect to many of them. So that they are providing here, which is it's very useful. They have many breaking news. So even like if you want to check about the market sentiment, you can also get from here. So rather than just I'm showing here, I just pick up some stuff here, but they also provide many. So you can just go check, and then some are price. They have like a price here. For example, I'm not sure, financial statement. Okay, let's go to here. They don't have final pricing here. So so that this one is basic, but Pro, Ultra, Mega, whatever, they are a bit costly based on the data, based on the company. But anyway, also you can check about the popularity or latency, that kind of things. So I can recommend this one too. Alright, so that's it for today. By the way, recently I released my own book about how to analyze US stock data with Python. And this is basically mainly focusing on the fundamentals. So of course, like you want to invest your money into the good company only. Like for example, I just show you here. This one is, I didn't show you this. So this one is Dow Jones 30 with the fundamental data. So what I can do is I put like this 30 the Dow Jones ticker, and from there I check about over 20% the growth from in terms of the revenue and the profit growth. I put here and then filtering and then excluding the less than 20%, and then I filter, and then eventually I list out, and then here you can see like a total revenue. Walgreen, the total revenue is high. Apple is a second. Profit wise, Apple is higher than Walgreen here. Microsoft is also coming here. And then if I check about this income, like the profit growth, and also the revenue growth here, the Apple is the top here. The rest of the company, we can just see like right top is always good. So the IBM is still good. Visa is not that good, but still, since they already list out and they screen out, all of these companies still more than 20% growth quarter by quarter, which is very good. We can see about the fundamental. Fundamental is very, very important. Let's say like you don't want to put the money into the GameStop, because the GameStop is the fundamental is not that good, but still the price is going, because that is kind of user's game. But if you want to have like a steady, nice, good growth company, then you can just check from here. So this is I explain also I check about it. So this is a growth rate, sums up of the profit and the revenue, and that is here x axis here. So Apple is growing well, IBM is here. The PSR is, as I mentioned, if this PSR is high, that means its PSR is low. That means like very low, lower value, the undervalue. So, so this Walgreens, Dow, TOW, IBM, all of them are very low PSR, PS ratio. I explained that kind of things here. So if you, 2 weeks ago I released this one, already 2,000 people copied, downloaded, bought. So maybe like, you can just go check. Okay, this is the current YouTube channel here. If you want to know about our previous past session, you can just go check from this YouTube channel. So that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy. Do you have any question? I'm not sure if you guys have. Okay, so that's it for today. Hopefully you enjoy and you learn something today. Okay, that's it. Thank you so much. I will see you next week, and then the next week I will talk about let's go to the meetup here. I will talk about the programming session. So this one is a financial programming, and then I think the next week I will talk about the psychology of the financial psychology. Means like they have like I will talk about 10 indicator, or actually I can say like the 10 different like psychology. Anyway, I will talk about that time. So hopefully I can see you guys next week or another week too. Okay, that's it. Will you have the lesson on coding? Yes, I have the coding session next week. Yeah. No question from me. Thank you very much. Oh, thank you so much. All right.